Good morning, everyone. It's Monday, March 8th, and this is Marv Eisen from Timeless Dollar. And today, what can we expect of the S&P mini market, or what can we expect of the stock market based on the news over the weekend? And that news, of course, is the passage in the Senate of the massive coronavirus relief package, a $1.9 trillion package. Let's see what the ramifications of that has been. On Friday, and I'm going to go quickly to a one-day chart of the S&P. This is the E-mini, but it reflects the S&P. This is Monday. And on Monday, the market was up, the S&P was up 73 points, almost 2%. Basically, there was exuberance, and it was a late-day rally that caused this to happen. But at any rate, let's go to what's going to happen today. Starting with the economic calendar, remember, we always need to look at the economic calendar to see what announcements are going to be made. Today, 10 a.m., wholesale inventories will be announced. It's nothing that's going to move the market. We can move on to the CNBC site, and we can see that Dow futures are up, S&P and NASDAQ futures down. Oil, well, slightly down as of now, but oil is up. Oil was trending towards $70 Brent crude, and this is in observance of interest rates. Remember, oil is not a commodity that's based on supply and demand. It's based on oil companies maintaining their profits. Wasn't that long ago when there were reports that oil storage facilities were full and there was nowhere to put the oil that was being offloaded from these tankers. The tankers were basically being told to stay out at sea. And right now, with oil prices rising, you figure that one out. 10-year treasuries, of course, 1.591, call it 1.6%. That is going to be, I think, the one thing to watch that's going to weigh most heavily upon the stock market, rising interest rates. Sectors, again, this is the performance as of Friday. Rising tide floats all ships, and here we see the result. All the sectors were up. Going back to the E-mini market, let's go to where we are starting out on Friday. Friday, we ended up 38.37. Today, March 8th, here's the March 8th candle, pre-market trading. Let me drill down to the 5-minute chart on this. And as of, let's see, just about 8 a.m., prices were up from 38.11, now 38.41. So pre-market, big move up 30 points. Will that hold true for the market? Today being Monday, I usually talk about a fog of war move on a Monday. And if you've taken my course, you know what the fog of war move refers to. Won't go into it right now, but I wouldn't be so sure that I would jump on a move to the upside right away at the market open. I think that could be a head fake today. At any rate, today is going to be a day of gyrations. I think bulls and bears are going to be particularly at each other's throats in contention for their indication of which way they feel the prices are going to go. So I would be very cautious trading today, Monday, March 8th. Anyway, that's my call for the market today. Be safe, trade with much patience, and remember, if you're looking for a way to make money using the S&P E-mini market, take my course at timelessdollar.com. It's called Trading Mastery for Financial Freedom. It'll save you a lot of money, a lot of grief. Anyway, you have a great day. Trade safe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on my next video.